Now, the next is, after getting this, I got J3 of x is equal to, from the first term and the last term, you can take J1 of x common. So J1 of x as common, we can write 8 by x square minus 1 and minus 4 by x J0 of x. So this I got as J3. So what we want to prove, that is we want J4. So consider what I do, the best thing is I consider this as equation number 1, this as equation number 2. So I substituted 1 and 2, and now I consider this as equation number 3. So further, let small n is equal to 3. So we write J4 of x, that is equal to 6 by x J3 of x minus J2 of x. So already I have got J3 of x, let's substitute. So 6 by x, J3 of x is 8 by x square minus 1 multiplied to J1 of x. Further, minus 4 by x, J0 of x minus J2 of x. So after solving this, I get 48 divided by x cube minus 6 by x, that is first term, multiplies to J1 of x, minus 24 divided by x square J0 of x minus J2 of x. Now further, J2 also we can substitute as, since I have J2, so I'll do one thing. J2 I have here, so I substitute this, so which I can write as J2 as 2 by x J1 of x minus J0 of x. So further, I can write this as 2 by x J1 of x plus J0 of x. So finally, from here and here, I can take J1 of x common. So which gives me 48 divided by x cube, and this gives me 6 minus 6 minus 2 minus 8 by x multiplies to J1 of x. And the second is, from here and here you can take J0 common. So that comes 1 minus 24 by x square multiplies to J0 of x. And that proves J4 of x is equal to this, which we wanted to prove. So that completion of my problem. Thank you for watching video on in 5 minutes.